Hey guys, so it's me, Nicolette Mashile, and today I want to talk a little bit about one of my most embarrassing money moments that I still think of today, and I get so upset because had I just known, things probably would have been a little bit better. Remember that none of my videos constitute as financial advice. If you are looking for financial advice, please do consult a financial advisor, one that is registered with the FSB. It's called the FSCA now, whatever. Anyway, so a few years ago when I was still driving Kedibone, for those of you who don't know who Kedibone is, Kedibone was my old girl who was a polo, and she was Snow White, and I used to love her. And I named her Kedibone because the car had really been through everything. It had seen everything. Kedibone literally translates to I have seen it all. I had gotten the car. It was my sister's ex-boyfriend's car that he had bought, that belonged to someone else, but they had bought it at second hand. It was just a mission. Let's just say when I got it, it was sitting on 300 and something thousand kilometers, so it had gone through a lot, which also then meant that some of its features, especially inside the car, meant that they were not up to scratch and up to standard. And one of those was the car radio. So sometimes the car radio, you'd be there jamming to a full song, full blast, gumnandi, hey siyachayva, hey simnandi, and then pa, no sound. And literally there will be no sound. Now obviously at that point when I got the car, I didn't really have a big problem with it because it wasn't a new car, so I wasn't really expecting miracles. But it gets a little embarrassing when you're driving to coffee there on Witkoppen and all of a sudden the music just goes dead and we literally have crickets because now you can hear the car, and the fact that I can't drive because now I'm revving the car and I'm stepping on it and I'm burning the clutch plate. Anyway, so Kedibone had a little bit of shortcomings, all right? So I remember this one day I ended up at Four Ways Crossing by some, I don't know how, I think I went there with a friend and he was looking for something else. And while I'm walking, when he's looking for his thing at Hi-Fi Corporation, I happened to walk there at the back, there where they put the car radios. The car radios, the big speakers, the amplifiers and whatever it is that they're called. And I kind of like gave it a glance. But you know when you give that glance, that khalilaring glance, that, oh, I wish I could type of glance. And you know salespeople, they are always on it. Salespeople are always on point, especially those who work at shops, because they can see through your soul. They know when you want something. And by, oh, like literally like a bell ringing at 5 o'clock, here comes a salesperson. He's like, my sister, I feel like you need a new radio. And I'm like, how do you know? And now I'm feeling like this guy knows my life, you know, because he's telling me I need a new radio. He's like, no man, look at this, let me show you this new one that we just got from Sony. It's got a USB portability, it's got an aux cable, you can actually make calls on it without your phone, so on speaker. And I was like, yo, imagine me, Kedibone, guys, and the phone rings and I don't have to answer it on the phone. I can just press on the radio, speak on the speaker. Imagine me, guys. You must remember this is back in 2012, okay? Now, I don't earn a lot of money at this point. Jeez, these birds, okay? I'm working as a teacher, not even a fully fledged teacher, an unqualified teacher at that. So you can understand and you can imagine what my salary is, right? So here I am standing in Hi-Fi Corp and this man is trying to sell me this radio, and I am sold. I am sold on the radio. I'm sold on the features. And he even throws in something and he says to me, baby girl, I will install it for you. So I'm just thinking, I don't even have to pay installers. Yo, guys, this is a great deal. So now I'm like to him, yeah, but I don't have 1,800. He says to me, don't worry, we will make a plan for you. And I should have known. I should have known the minute he said he's going to make a plan for me, that plan was not for me. The plan was for him and for his targets. Because I walked out of that shop, guys, having signed a financing deal for a radio that was going to cost me 1,800. 1,800 rand, and I had financed it. Can you help me understand how I'm financing a radio at 1,800? Why did I not just save for it? So, guys, I spent 2 years paying for that radio. 2 whole years paying for a radio. It did not even last because he installed it, number one. It played for maybe about 2-3 months and then something blew up in the radio. Apparently, it is spark plugs or something like that. Blew up in the car and the radio stopped working. And Kipi here did not even have insurance for it. So you can imagine, because now on Kedibone, obviously you're getting the basic insurance, which means that you're not covering no radio. Even when I got the car, I did not have a radio that was working properly. So there was no way I was going to add a radio there. So generally, I did not have insurance for the radio, which meant that it was gone, guys. Like, it was gone. Do you know how painful it is to pay for something that you don't see and cannot use anymore? That was me and that radio. And I wish that somebody had explained to me, number one, insurance, number one, the importance of insurance, but number two, how credit and interest rates work, guys, because that guy had charged me 23%. I was actually looking at the papers the other day. I was being charged 23%, because let me tell you what happened. So the furniture shop, or whatever they call themselves, I'm never going to say their name, they went and got financing from a bank. But so that they could also make money, they added on their own amount of interest. So they were getting interest from me for themselves, and then the interest that they were paying to the bank for this loan that they had actually taken out. Because basically, that was what it was. They had actually gone to a bank and took out a loan against a car radio on my behalf without even telling me, guys. So, you know, we always hear about our grannies and our aunts and how they are paying for the sofa, the ones with the plastic on top of them, for years and years. That's because that's what happens. These shops say to you, they offer you financing, but they don't actually offer you financing. They go to the banks and they get a loan against this furniture that you have taken, or against their great credit record, or whatever it is that they're using. You end up paying for a loan. Imagine taking out a loan to buy the sofa, taking out a loan to buy a 1,000 rand car radio. So yeah, man, I wish that I had known. I wish that there was somebody that had taught me about, you know, interest rates, credit, and insurance, guys. Insurance. You know, in my next video, I'm really going to talk about some of the things that as a grown-up you really should have in place if you want to be dealing with your personal finances. I just feel like by the age of 25 and above, there are certain things that you should have in place, and I'm going to do that in my next video. Let me do it right now, actually.